I first found out that I was going to be on the Supreme Court when the head of the Judicial Selection Commission called me and said, "Can you meet with the governor tomorrow?" And I said, "What? Does this mean what I think it means?" And, you know, he said yes, and I met with the governor, and it was just very, of course, I was really honored, but I was also very humbled, and I knew of the work of the court, and I knew how challenging some of the cases would be. So, you know, it's a feeling of just incredible delight to be put on the court, but you also know that you're undertaking a position of great responsibility. So there's, you know, kind of the awe of that. And I actually have a funny story. I mean, first I'll start with, you know, putting on the robe, because that itself is kind of maybe a hard thing to understand. But when you first put that on there, it's important. That robe is really important because it makes you not so much Margaret Cudich anymore, but you are a member of a body, of an institution that plays a really critical role in our society. And so that robe reminds you of that. And when we come into our courtroom every day, this courtroom, the Capitol courtroom, we look up on the walls and there's the word lex in four different spots, which means in Latin, law. And so that's another visual reminder that it's not you as an individual, and that all of the justices serve under the law and are trying to, you know, do what is required for justice. So, but I did have a funny experience the first day that I came on the court when this Capitol courtroom was under construction. So we were in the judicial center for the whole, I would say, 6 months or so when I first got on the court. And then we came over here to this newly revitalized courtroom that I was very familiar with. But when I came here to argue, it sort of had a shabby genteelness. I mean, you could tell it had been a really great room at one time, but it had lost a lot of its luster. So I didn't have time to come look at it before we had our first argument here. So, and I had never seen the back area, you know, where the justices go to confer and what was behind the red curtain there. So I was coming to it from that angle. And I don't know, I put on my robe, and we had some extra time before we were gathering in the conference room, and then we come in formally. And so for some reason, I just thought, what's behind that curtain? You know, I mean, I was on the other side of it. So I just go like this. And of course, there are all the people in the courtroom and the attorneys. And I just kind of went like that. And it was just one of those moments where I was like, well, that was kind of silly. But then when I came in the courtroom, it was all I could do. I mean, you have to listen so carefully when the parties are giving their arguments. But what I really wanted to do was just let my jaw fall open and look at these incredible murals up on the ceiling that before you could see that there were figures and things, but you couldn't really even tell what the stories were about. So it was all I could do to focus on the argument. And then after we finished that day, I came back in and just took it all in, all the detail. And I must say that every day that I work in this courtroom, I just pinch myself, because it's like, who else has such, you know, what a wonderful environment in which to do your work. And I think in some ways, I hope in some ways, that it calls us to our better natures. You know, that these inspiring words and these inspiring murals help us to remember that, you know, this is about really justice for the citizens of Minnesota, and we need to do our part in this work to make sure that everybody's heard and everybody gets a fair hearing and everybody really feels like they've had a decent shot at justice when they come into our court.